So the function, the main function of the hippocampal formation is memory. And we know that if you mess up your hippocampal formation, then you are no longer able to create new memories. So what is memory? Well, obviously the ability to remember things. We have a couple of different kinds of memory that I want to talk about in the next several slides. So we have short-term or working memory and long-term memory. Short-term memory, when I was a young person, it used to be you looked up a phone number in a giant book called a phone book, and then you would go to the phone and dial it and then immediately forget it. Today, since everything's already on your phone, that kind of isn't a really good example of short-term working memory. But a student of mine told me it's simply doing like mental math, like trying to figure out the tip at a restaurant, or simply adding in your head or subtracting in your head or doing simple math in your head is an example of short-term or working memory. Long-term memory is what I hope you take away from this course and all the things that you remember about the nervous system that you'll be able to use and apply in your future coursework. There are also, there's two types of long-term memory, explicit or declarative memory, and this even has two subdivisions. So explicit and declarative memory falls into two categories, episodic, think of the episode of a TV show, and it's what happened. So episodic memory, long-term memory, and it's what happened. More explicit memory, long-term memory, declarative, that has to do with words or facts is semantic memory. So long-term memory can be classified as explicit, episodic is what happened, and semantic is the facts. The other type of long-term memory is implicit memory or non-declarative. And this is basically how to do something, how to ride a bike, how to use a hammer, all of those kinds of things that don't necessarily have words involved, but are motor memories, are implicit memories, and still they are long-term memories. So what do I want you to take away from this lecture on the hippocampal formation? So I'd like you to remember, what are the three parts of the hippocampal formation? And so when we say hippocampus, we're really talking about hippocampal formation. What are those three subdivisions? What areas of the cortex project to the hippocampal formation? To what areas of the cortex and diencephalon does the hippocampal formation project? What is an explicit memory? What's the difference between episodic and semantic? And what is an implicit memory? You understand all of these concepts, then you're ready for the assessment.